dissonate.
Francis Bacon is generally accepted as one of the half dozen best painters in the world. No other British painter of this century has been held in anything like such high esteem. He can't produce enough work to keep up with the demand for it from museums and private collectors. Fame has made no difference to his way of life. He's refused honors, he's uninterested in position and possession.
Painting has now become, or all art has now become, completely a game by which man distracts himself. What is fascinating actually is that it's going to become much more difficult for the artist because he must really deepen the game to be any good at all and return the onlooker to life more violently.
I've always been very moved by the movements of the mouth and the shape of the mouth and the teeth, and I like the, you may say, the glitter and colour that comes from the mouth. And I've always hoped, in a sense, to be able to paint the mouth like Monet painted a sunset, but I've never succeeded in doing it. But I was also very influenced by the Eisenstein film, the Potemkin and the Odessa set sequence, in which there's this wonderful shot of the nurse screaming. And also, when I was first went to Paris, I found in an old bookshop a book on diseases of the mouth, which was beautifully coloured, hand-coloured, the plates were hand-coloured, and that it had a tremendous effect on me. And I don't know if this obsession when I was much younger with the mouth has a lot of sexual implications, as people say it may have, and I believe the psychologically it is supposed to, but anyhow, whatever it was, I was at that time very obsessed by that image.
So you might well have been interested in painting open mouths and teeth, even if you hadn't been painting the screen.
I think I might.
Nevertheless, yes. You did become involved with painting the human screen.
I did, and I've always hoped, I've always wanted and never succeeded in also painting the smile, but I have never been able to do it.
I'm not sure if I can remember exactly when I first saw a picture by Francis Bacon, but I would have been very young. I mean, he's always been my favorite artist. I just find a tremendous atmosphere to his paintings, a sort of moving quality. I think there are, for me, suggestions of distortions of and memory in the way the faces are portrayed, in a way that I found fascinating. In various ways in my work, I've tried to echo or represent it in cinematically.
I think I'm very, very drawn to the bleakness of it, really, because I think whilst it might be emotionally uncomfortable, the bleakness of what it's trying to present there, it makes you think about the limitations of human experience and human understanding of our own place and things and all of that. Heath and John Caglioni, as makeup artist, and myself are trying to figure out a way to take the clown makeup but make it more threatening somehow, more real world, and texture it, really. And I wind up taking a book of Bacon paintings in and showing them a lot of the different distortions of the way the paint would run together and the colors would mix. And we wound up applying that to the makeup and letting it have a sort of slightly worn through quality. And sweaty. I think what Heath was able to do with his makeup, with the makeup artist, is kind of really uses his face as a canvas, you know, and really try and achieve some of that tortured quality and some of that threat in the actual makeup of the Joker.
and so on. And yet people have a sense that your work as a whole is horrific. Why do you think this might be?
Well, I don't think so. I mean, you may say the carcasses of meat. It's true that when you go into a butcher's shop, you see the beauty of the meat, how beautiful meat can be.
The thrill of standing in front of a work of art, particularly Marlborough Gallery, standing in front of a work of art by Francis Bacon. Something happens.
And all of us know the painting or the photograph or the film remains the same, but it's the viewer that is the magic part of the whole process. It's like a love, a thrill. Certain things light the heart and the mind simultaneously. It's like a beautiful storm comes over us, a thrilling, beautiful storm, deep love and a flow of excitement in the brain. It's it happened with seeing Francis Bacon's paintings.
Thank you. exists. Are you real? To me, you're real. There you are. There you are, Melvin Bragg. You are absolutely real to me. There you are, flesh and blood, before me. How are you going to remake that? That's be a real... How are you going to make that in another art?
This is the manifesto of Mother Monster. On Goat, a government-owned alien territory in space, a birth of magnificent and magical proportions took place. But the birth was not finite, it was infinite. As the wombs numbered, and the mitosis of the future began. It was perceived that this infamous moment in life is not temporal, it is eternal. And thus began the beginning of the new race, a race within the race of humanity, a race which bears no prejudice, no judgment, but boundless freedom. But on that same day, as the Eternal Mother hovered in the multiverse, another more terrifying birth took place, the birth of evil. And as she herself split into two, rotating in agony between two ultimate forces, the pendulum of choice began its dance. It seems easy, you imagine, to gravitate instantly and unwaveringly towards good. But she wondered, how can I protect something so perfect without evil? It doesn't matter if you love him or capital H-I-M-M-M-M-M-M. Just put your paws up, 'cause you were born this way, baby.
My mama told me when I was young, we're all on superstars. She pulled my hair, put my lipstick on, in a glass of her boudoir. There's nothing wrong with loving who you are, she said, 'cause he made you perfect, babe. So hold your head up, girl, and you'll go far. Just be a queen. Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Give yourself prudence and love your friends, so we can rejoice the truth. In the religion of the insecure, I must be myself, respect my youth. A different law is not a sin, believe capital H. I.
Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Whether you're broke or evergreen, you're black, white, beige, Chola descent, you're Lebanese, you're Orient. Whether life's disabilities left you outcast, bullied or teased, rejoice and love yourself today, cause baby, you were born this way.
No matter gay, straight or bi, lesbian, transgender life, I'm on the right track, baby, I was born to survive. No matter black, white or beige, Chola or Orient me.
This way.